I've been thinking about logo design. I'm going to cover a couple different things. First, I want to say my background is originally in graphic design. I spent 15 plus years in the graphic and web design field. I redesigned the logo for the first company I ever worked for. And then when I started taking client work and sort of quit my job, I did quit my job and was just working independently and was working for clients. I've designed a number of logos for different clients. And so I'm going to cover a number of things about designing a logo, how to design or get a logo, right? If you're not a designer, how much to charge, and also some other things you want to know just from my experience of designing logos, things that you may want to know. Sometimes a really good logo just makes your job easier. And what I mean is, it's very easy to design a set of business cards or design a website if the company has a really nice logo, because it's just not hard to make it look good. And I've designed websites for companies that already had a logo and the logo didn't look good. And it was just a lot harder to make the website look good. You kind of have to think hard about how am I going to make this look nice. You got a sweet logo on there, make sure the colors look nice, find a really awesome template and slap that awesome logo on there, and you got a good looking website there. So, that being said, how do you design a logo? What if you're not a designer, right? Well, there are a number of different ways that you can go about getting a logo. The first one would be if you have some design and technical skill, there are logo makers out there. I know one, for example, is logomaker.com, logo maker with no E in maker. And it's kind of like a mix and match. You find their, you use an icon that they have, and then you choose some text, and it's like a simple designing system. There are a lot of different ones out there. I've heard good things about Logo Maker, but there are a lot of others out there as well. This is like if you have really good design skills, you're maybe not necessarily like a full-out designer, but you have some good skills in that area. You've done some website design, you know how to make things look good, then that's something that could be a potential way that you could do it yourself. An advantage of something like this is the final sort of product that you get is very inexpensive. I think the paid download, they say it's free, but if you want to pay for like an actual copyrightable usable logo, I think it's like $19 or something. A lot of times you'll hear, well, these are really good because they're really inexpensive. But if you are designing a logo or getting a logo designed for a client, then remember that something like this is not inexpensive for you because it's going to take your time. So, what other options do you have? If you're not going to be making it yourself, you don't have any design skills, actually, I think you're in really good shape because there are a couple different options for you. One is something like a logo contest. And basically, the way it works is you sort of put a contest out there and you get a number of submissions kind of in rough draft form. And then you choose one or a couple, and you kind of work with the designers to sort of like tweak the design a little bit, and then you choose one and you pay for it. 99designs.com is an example of something that will let you do a logo design contest, and I think they start at like $299 is the lowest price at least at the recording of this video. The lowest price is $299, and then you get a logo out of that. So that's another option. And basically, you would be working with the designers that are in your design contest, but then you're also working with your client. So you're kind of acting as a go-between in that case. This is a nice middle ground, okay? It's gonna tend to be a little less expensive. You're gonna have a lot of different options, but you're still getting a logo designed by an actual designer. The last option I'm gonna talk about is actually working with one professional designer, a freelancer, or somebody who has a job but they're freelancing on the side or something, who can design a logo for you. The thing I would say as a former freelance designer, this is gonna get you a good quality design and probably good service, provided you find a good freelancer. And there are services out there where you can find freelancers, like, for example, Upwork.com would be a good option for a place to look for designers who are looking for work and get some quotes from a number of different designers. There's two things you always need to think about when you're working with a designer. One is whether they do good work, and two is whether they're good to work with, which includes communicating well with you, communicating well with your client, right? If you're bringing on a freelancer, maybe you just want to bring them on as part of your team, right? And have them work with your client on designing the logo. That kind of takes it out of your hands, right? You don't have to worry about it. But in that case, you need somebody who's really good at working with clients. They deliver work on time. They deliver work on budget. Those kinds of things are all the sort of intangibles of getting logo design done or any kind of design work done with a designer. And so if you're looking for a freelancer, talking to some people you know who have gotten design work done, did they have a good experience? And then go to the person's website and see what kind of work do they have there. Do they have logo design work there? You know, if you can, the best thing is if you know people who got logos, who got a logo design done, and they liked who they worked with, that's the best situation. It's been great talking to everybody. Take care.